Are you shaking the car?
Oh, that's fucking weird. Are we having an earthquake? Anyways, good morning, and I'm wearing my Outer Rights earrings today because I look like a boy, and I don't know if I'm gonna have time to do my makeup, and I don't want people staring at my face. Like, I don't know, like, just don't look at me. But yeah, today we're closed half a day, my clinic, because we have training and stuff, but honestly, the training to me is pointless. Like, commander's calls to me, I don't understand them. Send it in an email. Like, that's what you always tell us. Send me it in an email. Well, send me it in an email, because I don't want to sit here and listen to you talk. Like, and half the time it has nothing to do with me, because I work in a pharmacy. I don't talk to any of those people. I do my own thing, and I go home. I'm headed to work. No appointments to view today yet, unless someone hits me up during the day and likes, like, hey, girl. We got a show in today at 4 or 5 o'clock. But like, at this point, I'm completely, I don't know, I'm not completely over it, but I'm kind of over it. Cause I'm just like, I'm not gonna find anything that I want. I was gonna get the balls to text that one lady on the street right across from the beach. But she was like really rude to me the first time I tried to talk to her. She was like, can you even move in by the 7th? I was like, okay, I'm not even about to text her back. Cause she was just rude. You know what I mean? She's like, I don't think I can hold my apartment that long. But yeah, it's still listed, honey. It's still listed. It's still listed. Oh yeah, there's one in Redondo I'm supposed to call today. So maybe we'll check that one out. But I don't know. Other than that, I'm just like, if this one's not it, I'm done. Cause I can't do it no more. It's so stressful. You're wasting my gas. I gotta drive all the way to go see the apartment. It's just no. It's just no, 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 no.
Cause I'm a lady. Yes, I'm a lady. Hey. I talk with a mouthful, but I couldn't be sweeter. Yup, I'm a cutie in my own way. I won't play, follow the leader. And I don't look like them, I ain't worried about it. I don't talk like them.
Redondo Beach.
Okay, and what was your name again?
Kiara. But you have to come here first, and then I'm going to show you the apartment.
Okay, so Saturday at 12.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. See you then.
Thank you so much.
Okay. She's so damn slow. My door's broke.
I think it's time.
I was on the phone with an apartment complex.
Oh. I was like, ooh, I'm just gonna park my car here and have her drive.
Park where?
Right there. Oops. Are you recording?
Yeah. Oh. I'm here with Ashley Jean. Where the fuck are they going?
Picking up people.
I'm so hungry. I'm gonna hop on my highway. So I can just pull in.
Pull in.
My air stinks.
I smell your thing.
This?
Oh, she still has her microwave.
Yeah. And I still have my Chick-fil-A.
Ew. You're nasty. You're nasty.
So this morning,
every morning I have to change Wyatt into a new diaper when he gets to daycare. He had just peed, so I take the diaper off. This bull peed, and it went all the way, his shirt, his face, all over the mat. I was like, This is how we're gonna do it today. This is how we're gonna be. I'm so done with him.
That was so funny.
I swear, mom life. It's ridiculous. Cause I still haven't found
a voice.
Shut up. Use a bitch. I still
Ashley
haven't found what I'm looking for. And that is.
You ever thought about putting Wyatt in like
acting? Models?
Anything. Modeling? Like you can start right now, just take pictures of him, post them, and yes. Have people vote, and you can get prizes and stuff.
I actually want to start because he is the cutest baby ever,
and he's
I'm not
nice.
Biased. Well, he hasn't been nice this past week.
Well, he's like, he's not a crybaby.
Not this past week.
Well, if any, like he's not, like, yeah, he don't know strangers.
No stranger danger yet. I hope he stays
ever,
that way.
Yeah, because like, what's her name? Yazid's. Haima's like that, but her other baby, hell no. That baby needs to holler.
Her kids are so
She's
adorable.
Getting, Ray's getting Kaima agent.
She's what?
She's getting Kaima agent.
Oh, I need to get my kid an agent.
Yeah, that's what I was like, shoot, you're in LA.
Shoot, he needs to make me some money because he's
That's what I told him.
Money.
I was like, I don't know how y'all in LA ain't got kids and don't use them.
I should. You want to go with us?
She said herself. Remember the? Were you there or was that Deanne? No, it was Deanne. We went to Subway or something. I don't remember. She said the last time. She said every time she get drunk, she got to go to the hospital and have them basically hook an IV up to her.
Wait, I was at Subway with y'all. Was
when she me? Said that? No, the last time we went, you had
time.
What's the Galati thing or something?
That's right.
I was like, what? Why do you get so that messed up? I said, when I drink, I just go to the hospital and let them basically pump her.
You know, there's actually clinics here in LA that will do that for you. Like,
that's
it's like
so
a hangover cure.
Stupid.
If you gotta do that, that means you should know.
You should probably slow down.
Slow your
roll. Like, once I get that drunk, I'm not having no more fun.
No, you throw up in a club
yeah,
and get
exactly.
kicked out.
Right. After I had fun, though. I threw it all up. I was good. I was sober. I was like, I swear I'm not drunk because I just puked it all out.
I was just standing there like, I don't even know what to say. That was funny.
That was so, I can't even say that was embarrassing because I was drunk and I don't, like, I remember it, but it's like, when you're drunk, you don't care.
You so fast though.
It was like, hit us.
He's like, let's go. I was like,
said,
we just got it.
At first, I was like, oh, cool. Because there was another bouncer. I seen him.
Yeah.
He's seen me throw up and he didn't say anything. And then that little short black guy comes.
Of course.
And he grabs me by my arm. I said, what?
Rude.
What are you doing? I was like, what are you talking about? It was an accident. It's like, that's not even throw up. That's just miss.
I feel like I choked on the ice cube.
Out of a shot. An ice cube in my shot.
Hey, you wanted it cold.
Oh, Hennessy, never again.
That was the worst shot of my life.
I was just like,
I almost threw
no.
up too.
Yo, they're gonna be like, oh, he knows me. Maybe he'll let me in.
Did you leave it?
No. What the fuck is he doing? Is that Tony?
Yeah. Oh, Tony's back.
Is that Tony? Am I waving at someone weird?
No, it's Tony. He can't see you though.
This me. Blaze pizza.
Blaze
pizza.
They do blaze it up in there or what?
Yeah, they put marijuana in your slices.
Wait,
what the hell?
I'm the one.
You're
looking a little shady.
Is there parking?
Probably the fuck not.
Nope. All these people need to move their cars and like.
But watch, I'm gonna go the illegal
45
way.
45 minutes. I'm not part of this if you go the illegal way.
Duh, you're the passenger.
No, I'm not even.
Let
here.
Me roll my window up.
You know, oh, there's a spot right there.
I gotta hurry so nobody sees me. I hate when, like, why you got your little ass car in that spot?
Oh, that's,
get out to somebody else.
What's his face? What are you gonna do, a Yui real quick?
No, I'm gonna back in so they know that I parked there. Yeah. They know I came in the back way. They're like, Emin Reed, how'd you get your car like that?
It wasn't me.
Sergeant Butis told
no,
me.
You better not. I'd be like, I don't even know who that is.
They gonna all know you lying. And the Lord said, let there be light.
I was asking Deanne, like, how church was, and she's like, it's just, like, it was a typical black church. And I'm like, what's a typical black church?
You haven't been to a black church?
No.
Somebody on here got offended when I said that.
I saw that.
Oh, you seen their comment?
Yeah. I follow you.
And I was like, that's, y'all, they, people know what I mean by black church. Y'all know what I mean. They just take forever. Black people like to talk. CP time. Message.
I can always expect you to be an hour late.
Damn, a whole hour? It's, you gotta tell me something's happening an hour before it's happening. Mm-hmm. I'm just, I don't know, lazy. Like, if something's going on at 11, I don't start getting ready till 10.
I'm always late now because I have a kid.
And then I'd be rushing. And I'd be like, why do I do this to myself?
I can. Did you have fun?
At church?
Was there any cute guys? Maybe I'm
Hell no!
I need to date the church boy.
Heck no! The only guy there our age was Lorenz.
Oh no.
Older. That's the only thing about churches. They're just older people. I want to go to a mega church. I know people don't like those, but I have more fun those.
I just like the singing.
See, they're singing it slow. That's what's like. I can't. I need something I can be like, come on, come on.
We should go to church.
All guys, Rosie. People.
Uh-huh. Are you shaking the car?
Oh, that's fucking weird. Are we having an earthquake?
I feel like we are. Are we? Their car's moving.
Is it, or are we?
Yeah, I see their thing moving.
I don't feel what I see.
No, their thing is moving. See in their car?
What the fuck?
That was an earthquake.
No way. Fast.
Hey, Siri. Did we just have an earthquake?
There were two earthquakes around your location in the last 72 hours. The strongest was magnitude 2.84, 11.2 miles south, southeast of Port Erwin, CA, last Tuesday at 8:29 a.m. Do you want to hear the remaining one?
No. We just had one. Cause they're, look at their.
Honestly, it wouldn't tell you that
rosary's
soon.
Rosary's not moving anymore.
That's so fucking crazy. His thing is not that strong to move, is it?
Yeah, no. And he's been there the whole time.
Is that what an earthquake feels like?
You never felt one before.
Just killed that bug.
Yeah, that is disgusting. You're nasty.
It's so my mirror. But guess what I got? Can you hand me those Windex? That's my second earthquake. We had an earthquake a few months ago. I was sitting on my couch. I was like, why the fuck is my couch moving?
I was like middle school, so fifth or sixth grade. We had an earthquake. And me and my brother shared a room, and we had a bunk bed. And he used to shake it all the time, right?
Oh, so you just thought it was...
Yeah, I woke up, and the room is doing this, the bed. And I'm like, Christopher, stop shaking it. And then my dad comes in,
bitch crazy.
We're having an earthquake. And we had to, like, go outside because we lived in a mobile home, and those things are not the best.
That's what I'm saying. Isn't it safer to be outside when there's an earthquake? Like, away from buildings, I feel like. All right, guys, I just got off of work. It is hot outside. It's always says 70 degrees. I think my car is broke. But yeah, there was a legit earthquake earlier, and I was just like, what the hell? I don't know. It was weird. I thought somebody was playing and like shaking my car, but it was a legit earthquake. Update. I got home. I showered. I have food in the oven that I'm about to eat. I'm not going to eat a lot of it. I really just want ice cream and to go to bed. I've had like a really rough, not day, obviously not day, but after work, basically, at first I literally fell asleep. I think I already told y'all that. I fell asleep at my computer. But anyways, after work, I went and I looked at that apartment.
I literally just drove by it and I was like, no, I'm not doing this. Like, it's literally, it's just not in a safe area. And I guess, like, I was like gonna tell you guys this earlier in the vlog, but I was like, I was too upset to talk. But it's like, I feel like some of you are gonna call me selfish. Not selfish, but spoiled. I don't even know. Somebody's gonna make something up. But like, growing up, I didn't grow up poor or anything. I mean, like, we had enough, you know what I mean? And it's like, here, I just feel like I don't have enough, if that makes any sense. Like, literally yesterday when I was talking about I don't get paid for this, I literally don't get paid enough to live in LA. Like, as an airman, you do not, they do not pay us enough. They don't pay us enough. And it's like, it's really bad because it's like, they don't want people, put it, the military is like, what, 50% divorce rate or something like that? But yet you sit there and you tell a single airman they get this much money, but oh, if you're married with a dependent, you'll get $700 more. And like, it's like, it's like a gimmick, you know what I mean? And it's just like, it's really irritating because it's like, you don't need $700 more because of an extra person, you know what I mean? Because most of the time, if you're married, that other person's working. It's just like, I feel like we're getting cheated on, basically. Because it's like, and then like, surveys come around every year and they're like, do you feel safe where you live? I always say no. Like, you're in the middle of freaking LA. People think, oh, it's so pretty. Yeah, if you have money. Those big houses you guys see, $1 million. Those nice YouTuber apartments, $3,000 a month. The military don't pay us no $3,000 a month to live. You know what I mean? Like, it's literally, it's like, to me personally, when they say, oh, we're taking care of our people, no, you're not. Like, I'm gonna get in, somebody's gonna find this video and try to snitch. I don't even care, because it's like, they need to know. Like, you're not, like, to me, I feel I cannot live comfortable here. That's why I was like, people are like, oh, you're gonna stay. I'm like, no, I can't afford to live here, even as a military member. I cannot afford to live here comfortable. If you ask most of the airmen, like, here, they like either live in Inglewood, San Pedro, like all the cheap areas. Like, it's not safe for them to live there, but they have to because that's all they can afford. And it's like, I got lucky here in Redondo. I got really lucky, but like, I'm barely making ends meet, you know what I mean? I'm still low-key living paycheck to paycheck because of how expensive is it. Like, they don't pay us enough. Like, I will sit there and stress that enough. I will say it till the freaking wheels fall off. They don't pay us enough. Like, I shouldn't have to basically downgrade from what I'm used to. And I didn't grow up a rich kid or nothing. It's just, I grew up comfortable. My parents were in the military too, but we were in Texas. You know what I mean? Put it this way. I'm gonna tell you, Texas BAH for an airman, I think it's like 14 or 15 a month. That's just for living. You can find a 3-bedroom home in Texas for like $1,000. And that's a nice home. Here in LA, a 1-bedroom apartment, a decent looking 1-bedroom apartment, like with all the essentials that you need, is gonna be at like at least 18. At least 18. It's freaking ridiculous. Like, it's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. I'm not like blaming LA, I'm blaming the military. Like, I literally, cause it's like, do y'all check on your airmen? Do y'all see where they live? Check out where they live. Like, y'all know LA is not the greatest place. Y'all know it's gang, all that, like the bad stuff. And they just don't, like, to me, they're not doing their job. But on that note, I'm gonna end this video before I get in too much trouble. yeah, I got my food going. I'm about to get on the computer and look for more apartments. I got some encouragement. I was like, I literally was almost like in tears earlier because I was like so upset. Like, I was like, this is it. This is all you guys are offering. This is it. Like, I was just getting so pissed off that I could not find a place that looked decent enough. That wasn't built in the freaking 1960s and still looks like the freaking 1960s. And there's freaking stains and shit on the wall. You know what I mean? It's like, do better. Do better. Both of y'all. The military and LA, do better. I'm so extra. But yeah, I'm about to get on the computer, look for some more stuff. Eat my food and probably just go to sleep. That's why I took a shower early. It's like 7:30 and I'm just like, I'm so over today. Like, I'm so over it. Like, I literally was driving around for 2 hours. The cool thing is, like, it's not cool, but I was driving. I drove past that first one and I was about to bust out in tears because I was like, this is ridiculous. Like, the neighborhood I drove in, I was like, this is not safe for me. This is not safe for me. But this apartment is in my house, in my price range. But this is not safe for me to live. So I was driving. I was about to drive home. Actually, I was going to go to the beach to calm myself down and just sit on the sand. And this guy calls me and he wanted me to look at his apartment. I was like, okay, maybe God is listening to me. Maybe he's like, Amy, shut up. Here you go. And he was like, oh, this one's in Manhattan Beach. I was like, okay, can I come now? He's like, sure. I get there. It looked like crap. I looked inside. I was like, I guess I can do this. Literally in my head, I was like, I guess I can do this. I walk outside and I said, do you guys have laundry? Like, I said it just like that. Cause he's like an old man. And he looked like he didn't know what he was doing. I was like, do you guys have laundry? He was like, oh yeah, we have a laundry room in the back. This laundry room had one washer and one dryer. And I opened it and they were dirty. It's like, this is disgusting. It's disgusting. Then, okay, I was like, after that, I was like, I'm gonna just go home because this is pissing me off. Another guy calls me and he was like, I got an apartment somewhere. I can't even remember. I was getting phone calls back to back to back and I was just like, what the fuck is going on? I don't know. But I answered. I was like, maybe this is a sign. So I go there. Everything looked nice. It was small. It was really small. Everything looked nice inside. It's not the nicest neighborhood. It's not the nicest neighborhood. But I was like, I can do with this because the door to the actual big apartment building, it locks. So if somebody break in, they gotta break in twice. You know what I mean? But the stove was literally this big. It was like a half of a stove. They renovated the whole place. Kept the old ass toilet that they had. And the bathtub. Put a new sink. New mirror. You can tell, like, the floors are brand new. They just put them in yesterday, he said. New kitchen cabinets, everything. And they have this stove from like 1950. And the toilet from 1950. And the bathtub. I was just like, I am so, that's why I'm just like, I need to just do the Long Beach one. Like, I'm just gonna be in the hood, but at least when I go inside of my house, I'll feel at home. You know what I mean? Like, it's to the point where it's just like, I'm so done. I have another one though, scheduled for Saturday near this house. We're gonna keep our fingers. Y'all need to pray for me. Pray for me. I've never asked people to pray for me. But y'all, I'm like seriously at my wit's end. I am so over, like, I am so stressed over somewhere to live. Like, that's ridiculous. Like, just wondering, basically wanting to be safe and feel at home. Like, I don't want no old dusty freaking apartment feeling like I'm poor. You know what I mean? People join the military so they don't have to be poor. But yeah, I'm still poor. I don't get it. I don't buy anything. When you guys see my shopping hauls, that's like what, once in 3 months? And I buy $6 shirts. Oh, guys, help me. See you all tomorrow. I will check back in. Saturday, I have that showing. So I'll keep you guys posted on how my life goes. And I can't stay in this apartment because I just found out that she's going up on rent. Because everyone in the city is competition. It's like, that's the thing about LA. These people are greedy. You're making enough money right now. Like, she's making money. Money. If y'all knew how much I pay in rent at this damn place. And there's like 40 other apartments the same size and paying the same price. if not more. These people are greedy here, y'all. I'm telling y'all.